set to bring you baseball from one of the crown jewels of the sport, venerable Wrigley Field in Chicago. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Philadelphia Phillies and the Chicago Cubs. It's Cubs baseball on the show next. Adbert Alzale, the right-hander from Venezuela, gets the starting nod in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Well, one thing to look out for him, Matt, is if he can avoid the big inning. It's not that big of a deal to give up a run here or there, but sometimes he can be prone to giving up three or four in an inning, and that kind of derails the whole start when that happens. Limit the damage, and he'll be just fine.
And now here is number 37, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Two and two. Good night for baseball all in all. Game time temperature 63 degrees. The 2-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher, but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Fouled off. Payoff pitch one more time. And he lays off ball four, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game.
And that at bat will put a smile on any manager's face. The pitch total of the opposing pitcher just keeps going higher and higher, and he still couldn't put him away. So this inning is off to a good start for the guys carrying the sticks.
And Bryce Harper will dig in at the plate. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Here now the 2-2. Nobody out, runner on first. Got him.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
To the plate now, JT Realmuto. Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1.
That's a great pitch for a spot like that. It looks like a strike, then it just comes in out of the zone. You can command that with movement. It's a very effective pitch to pitching hitters inside.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Happ is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Batting fourth, the first baseman, number 17, Reese Hoskins.
Two down with a runner at first, and that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Reese Hoskins. Hit sharply but foul down the right side.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home is swung on and missed. He got him. Phillies strand one, and now it'll be the Cubs' turn in a scoreless ball game. Zach Eflin gets the ball for Philadelphia in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Well, Matty, if you're looking for innings out of your starting pitcher, you're looking at the right guy. This guy seems to deliver more often than not, going deep into the games. He's one of those guys you feel really confident that could go into that seventh, eighth, and even the ninth inning, a workhorse.
Swung on and missed, one and two now.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
Hard sinker misses, two and two. And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, three and two.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Number 37 is there, and he has it for the out.
Batting second, the third baseman, Chris Bryant.
Digging in next will be Chris Bryant. Head-to-head at the start of play against Zach Eflin. It's been very good, 8 for 13. The 3-2 pitch. Skied into straightaway right. Harper has a read on it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Two down, no one on base. And into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. And a good job there to lay off. It's ball four as he becomes their first base runner of the ball game now with two away.
Batting fourth, the first baseman, Anthony.
Runner at first with two gone in the inning. And that brings in Anthony Rizzo. Baez is off of first with two away. Pitch out, nothing doing. Has a look, now the pitch. Baez breaks from first. Pitch misses low. The throw down. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Another look at the throw down that results in a third out on the bases. An inning in the books, no score on the show. So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. Fouled away. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Standing in now, Alec Bohm. Swing and a shot toward right center. And this is going to find the seam in right center and should get to the ivy for extra bases. And he'll pull into second with one away.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it, and he's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
At the plate, Gene Segura saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. Oh, behind the back. Throw not in time as he's able to leg it out.
Beggars can't be choosers right there. We love those long darts. Doesn't matter how they come. Jam off the end of the bat doesn't matter.
Into the box now, Ronald Torres. On the ground to second base, this could be two. To second for one, on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. One pitch, two outs, a pitcher's best friend in the inning. Through an inning and a half, no score on the show. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. The 3-1. Into center field, line drive, base hit. Now that had to feel good because it was one of those that you don't even feel the ball hit your bat. Showtrack tells us he blasted it out there at 115 miles an hour. So yeah, he squared it up about as good as you can. At the plate now, Wilson Contreras. On a line, that's a base hit.
Hey, two runners on after back-to-back singles right there. They are in prime position to put the first run on the board right here.
In now, Ian Happ. And he takes a cold strike at the knees, and that'll run things full. Pulled toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and head for third. And he'll indeed move up 90 feet, putting runners at the corners now with one away.
The right fielder. Jason Hayward.
The next Cub up, Jason Hayward. And they're runners at the corners now. The 2-2. Now this is on the ground to first. We'll see if they can get two. One there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Clearly enjoying their time here at the ballpark, as are we. Two complete. Still scoreless here on the show. Now to the plate, Zach Eflin. 9-1-2 due up. The 1-1 home.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Zach Eflin goes down for the first out here in inning number three. To the plate now, number 37. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two. Third inning, no score to this point. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1. Trouble waiting on deck as Bryce Harper hits next. The 3-1. And it's belted high and deep into right center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. The relay throw, but he is in there with a triple.
Here's another look at it right here as he drives it right between the two outfielders, heading towards the right center field wall. He was flying out of the box, so I think he was thinking triple all the way. By the time they get it back in, he's safely into third.
Standing in now, Bryce Harper. And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning.
Well, their chances of pushing across a run took a pretty good hit after that strikeout. It's so much tougher to score a guy from third with two outs instead of one. Basically, you need a hit, or you need to get lucky with a wild pitch or a pass ball.
So now to the plate, JT Realmuto. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. One and two count. Here's the pitch. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. One left for Philadelphia. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Sergio Alcantara. Now the 1-1 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch. And for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
At the plate, Advert Alzolay. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher, but sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
And this one is over, and he works the count back to 2-2. On a line, that's a base hit.
Boy, D-Row, that's awful scary from a pitcher's standpoint. But what's it feel like when you hit one as a hitter that you know is going right at a pitcher?
Yeah, it's scary from the offensive standpoint as well. You know, you're taught to hit it right back where it came from, but those moments right there make you cringe as you're coming out of the box. We got lucky with that.
Into the box now, Jock Peterson. All even now, 2-2. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Hit out towards second. Segura has it to second for one. On to first. And for the second time in three innings, they've bounced into a double play. And with this one, the side is retired. Cubs are down quietly. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Ball set for the start of the inning. And digging in is the big-time power threat, Rhys Hoskins.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
The 2-1 home. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue, or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
Hap will slide over and put this one away, and that's out number one. Here's Andrew McCutchen now, struck out in his first at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, Sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Hit hard on the ground towards second. He's right there. And there are two away now.
Up next.
So now here is Alec Bohm, one for one as he reached base with a double his first time up.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Phillies down in order. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Here's Chris Bryant now. He's 0 for 1 thus far. One and two now. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at two and two. Grounded to third, scooped up. Throw on to first, and one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away. So one away
nine.
Here in the Chicago fourth. And with it comes Javi Baez to the plate.
Baez.
Drilled right back up the middle. Oh, beautiful dive. The throw in time.
Well,
let's get another look at that
44.
Diving play on show track. Obviously a great job just to get the glove on it, and perhaps just as impressive was the throw to first. He got a lot behind that ball to nab the runner up the line. At the plate now, Anthony Rizzo. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. And another foul ball. And he has to fight this one off to stay alive as this is fisted foul off to the left side. And now pitch on the way. And he jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. Number 37 has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. Cubs are down in order. Through four, still tied, nothing, nothing. Welcome back to the north side of Chicago, back here at Wrigley Field as we check in with Heidi.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Joe Girardi during the commercial break about the Phillies' offense, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Despite the fact that they've yet to push a run across, the game is still tied, and the pitch count for their opposition is really getting up there. They think that making him work as hard as he has is going to pay off later in the game, and that they just need to stick to the process.
All right, thanks, Heidi. So stepping in is Gene Segura. He'll start off the fifth in this one. One and one, here it comes. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Cubs have someone working in their bullpen now as a right-hander's begun to get loose. The 2-1 home.
Ball three.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
Down the left field line. Segura turns and goes to second. And he is into second base with a leadoff double.
Now yeah, batting. I think he was sitting on the fastball, so he got the changeup. He was way out in front of it, but he kept his hands back long enough to keep it fair down the line. That's not always easy to do.
Now a pickoff play at second, and the runner back. Into the box, Ronald Torres. Down low, two balls and a strike. Hit on the ground out to short. Baez fields it cleanly. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away.
We talk about this all the time in the game, having an internal clock. That's exactly what he had right there. He had plenty of time to take an extra step and secure his grip on that throw.
Stepping in now, Zach Eflin. A one ball, two strike count to the Phillies pitcher.
He is in complete command out on the mound today. He's got all four corners locked in, and now he's raising eye levels to boot.
Lays off, 2-2 now.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Still even at 2-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Popped him up. Bryant is over, and he tucks it away for the second out. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, number 37. He made it to third on a triple in his previous appearance. And this is low, ball two, 2-1. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Segura at second with two down. Hit back up the middle. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0.
Boy, it's been tough to score in this one so far through the fifth inning, but that RBI base hit right there is a nice breakthrough.
Yeah, it's been a great pitcher's duel up until this point. They've been executing on the bump without question, but that RBI knock right there might set the tone for the later innings.
Standing in now, Bryce Harper. 3-1 now.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
One run, six hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four, and as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs, and now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Here comes the Chicago skipper now up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So he'll depart here in the fifth after working just 4 2/3. And he's on the hook for the L unless this one turns around. Ladies Keegan Thompson trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away.
Number 71, Keegan Thompson.
JT Realmuto will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch.
Well, he snapped that breaking ball off really nice. He'll do well to keep putting it there.
Two down, runners at first and second. Lifted down the line and left. And nearly a three-run shot. Instead, it's a foul ball. 2-2 pitch is fouled away. 2-2, here it is. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obvious.
We'll have to leave it there as the play is made for the third out. Phillies will have to be content with just the one. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cubs to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. No, they have not scored yet, but they have been successful in running up the pitch count, something they feel will eventually pay dividends on the scoreboard as the starter gets tired and they are forced to go to the bullpen. For now, they're sticking to the plan.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and now it'll be the catcher, Wilson Contreras. On the ground to the right side. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
The center fielder, number 8, Ian Happ.
And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Misses there for ball four, so runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
So that'll bring up Jason Hayward, trying here to plate the tying run from second. No runs, four hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Hard hit ball to short. Segura for one on the first, and a big ground ball there as they turn the double play on Hayward.
The bat.
Oh, that's a rally killer right there. They were in great shape with two on and nobody out. But the double play is the last thing you want in that situation. Just a runner at third now, but there's two outs.
To the plate now, Sergio Alcantara. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Contreras on third with two out. Swing and a liner. He's under it, and that ends the inning. One left for the Cubs. It remains 1-0. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up Rhys Hoskins. Here now the 2-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
In now, Andrew McCutchen. And that one yanked just foul. Here comes the 1-2.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
And it's fouled away. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
We've got ourselves an awesome battle going on right here. Bottom line, the guy who's going to win this situation is the guy who executes.
Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. tipped in the air down the line and left. Peterson on the run. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now batting.
Stepping in next, Alec Bohm. He was thrown out at second trying to stretch a base hit into a double in its last at bat.
Yeah, fellas, not sure if he got the go-ahead from his base coach or not. Can't believe he did, but it looked like he was running in mud right there.
A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Again, another foul ball. Here's another 2-2. On the screws to shortstop, but caught to retire the side. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They lead it 1-0. Patrick Wisdom is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six. Now the 1-1 pitch. Strike two swinging. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Here he comes again, 1-2. Hit the other way out toward right field. Harper has a read on it. One out. Here's Jock Peterson now. 24. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. Bases are empty, one man out. Two balls and a strike. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. High in the air into shallow left center. McCutcheon is under it. Two down.
The batter.
Next up, Chris Bryant. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one.
Bryant.
Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch.
His slider's been impressive all night long. If he can continue spinning it like that, he's going to be just fine.
The 2-2. Now a high fly ball headed for the corner in left. It has the distance. And that nearly would have gotten him on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball.
Huge swing of the bat right there. Just hooking foul. Would have tied the game. I know there's still a lot of game left, but that was potentially a huge momentum swing there. Going to have to find a way to
Loud contact off the bat of Bryant and sent deep to left. And this will kick off the base of the wall. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they could get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
At the plate now, Javier Baez. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. On to the back third tonight. Stick around on the show. Tommy Nance is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 45, Tommy Nance.
Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Gene Segura. Now the 2-1 pitch. And this is pop foul, but perhaps playable behind first. And this is taken in for out number one. Now at the plate, Ronald Urias. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. The 1-1 home. Hit in the air out to center field. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Now to bat, Zach Eflin. In his last at-bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. And it looks like the Cubs will get a left-hander up and working out of the bullpen. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. This one's blooped out toward right center field, and that'll get down for a base hit.
Hey, I've been impressed with this guy. Not only is he throwing the ball well, but now he's mixing in a base hit late in the game, giving his manager options whether or not he wants to pinch run, keep him in there, go to the relief. I mean, he's opened up a whole weaponry box for the manager.
Into the box, number 37, and he fouls this one off. Again, a 1-2. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Peterson giving chase. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Phillies strand one, but they're up 1-0. Bottom of the inning now, and into bat next, the left-handed hitting first baseman Anthony Rizzo. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. A bouncer up the middle. And that's through into center field. So the tying runs aboard to kick off the inning. It's like magic or something. He's given up a boatload of hits, but they haven't been able to chase a runner home.
And that's just another base hit in a long line of many. Seems like he's been pitching from the stretch the entire game, but somehow he's still got a shutout going. We'll see how long he can make this last.
Here comes the Philly skipper on his way out toward the mound. And we're going to see a pitching change, as that's going to do it for his starter here tonight. So he'll depart with the lead and a chance to be the winner, but he is responsible for the tying run at first. Ranger Suarez comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number 7. At the plate, Wilson Contreras hit hard on the ground to second. That's through, a base hit, and he's got his third hit of the game.
That's the battle, Matty, working yourself into a 3-1 count, having count leverage and getting ahead to a fastball. You don't get too many opportunities throughout the course of a game to have full count leverage, and he took advantage.
Into the box now, Ian Happ. That one finds the target on the outer half. It's 1-2. Now some movement out in the Phillies bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. Possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Nobody out. Grounded softly down the line toward first. He indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now.
Now batting, right fielder.
Next to hit is Jason Hayward. A potential tying run for him at third base. fouled off. One out with the possible tying and go-ahead runs on base here. In the dirt and blocked behind the plate. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. He's ready. Now the pitch. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Hoskins is there. Two down.
Now back.
Great scoring opportunity miss right there. You talk about frustration. Popping it up with two runners in scoring position. He'd like to get that one back.
Striding in is Sergio Alcantara, trying to bring in the tying run from third here. Big spot. Two out, possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Struck him out, so they work out of the jam as he strands two men in scoring position. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. Back with more from Wrigleyville right after this. Ready to begin the eighth, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Bryce Harper. And one pitch is swung on and missed, and that's a full count now. Three balls and two strikes.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Fouled away. Full count still.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. Back goes Hayward, still ranging back into the bleachers and gone. A solo home run off the bat of Bryce Harper as the Phillies have taken a 2-0 lead.
And you know who's the happiest about that insurance run right now? The guys in the bullpen. They can now breathe a little easier knowing they have a bigger cushion to work with to close this one out.
Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Rex Brothers is on to pitch here in the eighth with nobody out.
Now pitching and batting in the seventh spot, number 48, Rex Brothers. Now playing right field and batting nine, number 66.
Stepping in now, JT Realmuto. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
Nice two-seam fastball there. You don't usually see a lot of swings and misses with that pitch unless it's really moving. So that one must have had some real good late life.
To the plate now, Rhys Hoskins. And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now 3-1. And now a left-hander will start to get ready in the bullpen. One out, nobody on. Yeah. Swung on and missed. That's strike two.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. He loses him on ball four.
Up next for Philadelphia, the left fielder, Andrew.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up the former National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. Hoskins, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. One and two as the changeup had him out in front there.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
Changeup, and that fades down and away, 2-2.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Working for the punch out and the offering, and it's fouled away. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Now the payoff pitch home is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. That was a nasty looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
In now, Alec Bohm. A bouncer to the left side. Bryant's got it. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. But the Phils tack on one more on this solo home run. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth. It's now 2-0 Philly. Jose Alvarado is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 46, Jose Alvarado.
Now at the plate here is number 66, and he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The count now at 2-2. Now the pitch. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw on to first in time, one away. Into the box, Jock Peterson flew out last time up.
Peterson.
And that misses, 2-1.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Now the 2-1. Full count, three balls and two strikes. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he fouls this one off. The next 3-2. swing and a liner. And that's the second out.
Up next to the Cubs.
Digging in next, Chris Bryant. Only four outs remaining for them to try and rally back in this one. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Good breaking ball, and it's in there. 2-2 now. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count, 3-2.
Reyes has it, and eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They're still down. It's 2-0. Brad Wick enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring in Gene Segura. Up high, 2-1 now. Even count, two balls and two strikes. The 2-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive for me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
Into the box, Ronald Torres hit down the third baseline. A dive, but it's off his glove. And they will not get him at first as he's able to leg out the throw.
Now back, the pitcher.
Luke Williams will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 30, Luke Williams.
Torres, base runner at first with one out. And he lays off ball four, so he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
Wow, you know he's not happy with that call. When it crossed the plate, it sure looked like a strike to me. Seemed to catch a ton of the plate. That's a tough way to give up a walk, but he's got to put it behind him now.
At the plate, number 37. And this one's in the dirt. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. Just hung in there on that one. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. Down the first baseline, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Left side, but well fouled. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
Standing in now, Bryce Harper. And that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2.
He got a swing and a miss on that last pitch, but that's not the location he wants to live in against a hitter of this quality.
And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. No runs, a hit, two left. Nothing in the Philadelphia ninth. Last chance coming up now for the Cubbies. They trail 2-0. Hector Neris comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Number 50, Hector Neris.
Here's Javier Baez. He's going to lead things off in their half of the ninth as they try to avoid the dreaded shutout.
It's never a good feeling to get shut out, and over the course of the season, it's bound to happen a few times. They've just been overmatched by good pitching.
The set and the 2-1 pitch. Liner to center field and a base hit, so early trouble to lead off the inning. The throw into second, the tag, and he is out at second.
Well, he clearly thought he had a shot at two on the hit, but they did a nice job in the outfield of getting it in quick to cut him down.
At the plate now, Anthony Rizzo. Here's a foul ball left side, and that'll move it to 1-2. And the pitch. Bases are empty, one man out. Popped him up. Hoskins has room in foul territory. Two gone.
Now batting.
Stepping up is Wilson Contreras. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. The Cubs are down to their final strike here. He stays alive, still 2-2. Two-run game, last of the ninth with two away. Another one sent foul.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes.
Well, this is a big pitch right here. Two outs in the ninth. The last thing you want to do is walk a guy and bring the tying run to the plate.
And now this will be the 10th pitch of the at bat. Swing and a line drive, but this is going to land foul, so they'll tee it up again. 3-2. One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
Man, as a pitcher, I can tell you that is so frustrating. He's got two outs, and he wants to get that third out as quickly and painlessly as possible, but that hitter makes him work his tail off, and he still loses him.
So now into the box is Ian Happ. His career numbers against Hector Neris. Not a big sample size, 0-1. Contreras, the runner at first with two gone. Happ with a 2-1 count now. Yeah. on the ground to third. Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Pretty efficient game right there. Low scoring, 2-0 game, well played defensively on both sides, and a couple of runs is all it took in this one.
This evening's game finishes 2-0 the final score. The Phillies used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Zach Eflin gets the W on the mound, so that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.